A long time ago, in Stardate 1886, deep into Brooklyn, the Chosen One was born. In a world where food is in constant threat of spoiling, the One discovered that an instantaneous freeze preserved the sacred freshness of their sustenance. Once thawed, this food restored perfectly to its natural form, ready for immediate consumption. The Chosen One was able to transfer his preserved products across galaxies to feed populations. His name was Clarence Birdseye.
Clarence Birdseye contributed to the manufacturing of frozen goods by creating his quick freeze machine. This founded a building block for the future of frozen food companies. The first to come out of the bunch was a small company called Stouffer's.
Ohio, 1922.
Abraham Stouffer! I want to open up a coffee shop!
My dear Mahala, isn't that a wonderful idea? We could also sell delicious homemade pies.
Why, Abraham, that's a wonderful idea!
Years later.
May I help you, sir?
I was wondering if I could get some frozen pies to go.
Well, ain't that a wonderful idea?
Many more years later.
Man, will I cry? Okay, I promise myself I wouldn't cry. Mom! Mom!
Papa!
I swear to you, I will carry out your legacy.
Let's go make some frozen dinner.
And so the sons of Abraham and Mahala Stouffer go on to create a frozen food franchise that led to the founding of the Stouffer's Food Corporation.
Okay, so now we have the first major food franchise that is specializing in frozen dinners in the 1950s. Stouffer's created dinners like meat pies and noodles Romanoff, and they were prepackaged frozen dinners. These became popular because when women started to enter the workforce, they had less time to prepare home-cooked meals, so women found it easier to cook already prepared foods that came in frozen packages.
And now, let's go to the moon!
As the astronauts arrived back at Earth,
Go!
What's going on, you guys?
Buzz, we're being quarantined.
I just want to go home and eat my wife's food.
Your wife doesn't make food anymore. She buys Stouffer's.
I made a trip to see if you guys have space cooties.
We have space cooties?
We're going to be here for 3 weeks, so I make sure you guys don't die from these space cooties. Now here, eat some Stouffer's.
I think he's dead. Did you kill him?
Okay then, let's talk about Apollo 11. You may think that this is a really random change of subject, but it's not. Stouffer's actually did participate in feeding the astronauts when they first came back from the moon in 1969. When the astronauts returned, they were required to spend 3 weeks in quarantine for fear of infecting the human population with extraterrestrial diseases. Stouffer's used this as a good promotion for their company, and they participated in feeding the astronauts their frozen dinners.
Since Apollo 11 was a big deal for the United States, Stouffer's created the ad slogan, "Everybody who's been to the moon is eating Stouffer's." This brought a lot of attention and media to the company. Everyone wanted to eat what the astronauts are eating, so they joined the bandwagon and bought the Stouffer's frozen dinners.
So all in all, the impact frozen food has had on society is
huge! Without companies like Stouffer's and inventors like Clarence Birdseye, we would probably not have the convenience of taking a meal out of the freezer and have it fresh or ready to eat in minutes.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Hope you've enjoyed the show!